And here you can see all the different Kasa TP Link devices that I have. You will notice that the power strip itself is not listed as a single item, but it actually breaks down each individual plug into its own item. So the plugs that are part of the power strip are the Drobo here, which is currently on, the Google, which is my Google Home Mini, which is currently off, and PlayStation, which is off, and I have an unused plug, which is showing the default name of plug 5 right now, Roku and TV. Now the Roku and TV are the ones that I've been using this for quite a lot. So let me show you what the individual options for the plug itself are. So we're going to start with the Roku. You can see you can power them down and power them on. So if I were to come over to Google, click on that, it will power it up. You won't hear it, but it's over in the other room and it's powering itself on. We're going to scroll down here and we're going to select the Roku. So from here you will see you'll have the title of the device up there, as well as a back button and a options or settings button. You have a big power button right in the middle there, as well as down here we have some options which I'm going to go over. First we're going to start with the settings options up here in the upper right. Here it will show you all of the devices and you can click on one to rename it or change the picture. You'll notice that there is a default picture of a plug. Hopefully you can see that. It's a little bright, but if you click on that, you can edit it and select a different picture. You can also use a photo that you've taken of the device, or you can just jump right in and take a picture and use that. I do wish that TP-Link would expand this. Fing, which I did a review over there, has a very good selection of default generic icons, and I kind of wish that those icon packs would become the default for everybody, but I do realize this is TP-Link's default and you could add your own if you wanted. Coming back, so we're back to the you can rename it, you can choose a picture. I'm going to go back one more time, and if we scroll down, we have other options. We can reorder the devices, so we can come here and say PlayStation 1, TV. So this is, you can see right there, hopefully it says plug 1, plug 2, plug 3. It's indicating where on the power strip that was plugged into, but maybe you don't necessarily want the Roku to be plug 6. You want to drag it up here and it's going to be listed as plug 1, even though its plugged in location is technically 6. I'm just going to bring that back down here because I really don't care. I use mainly the voice activated portions of this, so we're going to come back. LED status lights, so you can turn all those lights on or off, which is kind of nice because it is a bright white light and it can be a little distracting depending on where the power strip is located. So if you toggle it off, all the lights on the power strip will go off, including that activation light. So it's not just the lights for each individual plugged in item, it's even that activation light will turn itself off. You're not going to save yourself a lot of power because they're LED lights, but if you want a completely dark room, this is how you would do it. You just come in there and toggle on and off the LED lights. So that's kind of cool. Advanced, you have device info. Clicking that will show you a bunch of information about the device. So time zone, location sync, date and time, the network device it's on, model, hardware version, firmware version, and then down there is the MAC address. We'll not be showing you that. And if you wanted to, you can also select remove device from here. We're not going to do that because we like our device. Now, these lower icons are all the same for all of the items on the plug, so we're just going to talk about the Roku right now. You'll notice that there are dots right here at the bottom. I'll scooch that up a little bit. So you can see that there are dots down there. Scrolling through that will scroll you through the items on the power strip. Now, you'll notice there's a difference between plug 5, which isn't currently turned on, and the Roku, which is turned on, in that the circle is illuminated, but also the background is. And there's a nice animation when you turn on and off the plug. It's a neat little feature. It's not going to aid you in any way, but it's a nice little kind of extra bonus. So coming down to the bottom, we're going to select schedule. Scheduling devices, you can come up here to schedule the device. Now, this is turning on and off the device on a specific schedule. So depending on what you're using the power strip for, if it's attached to a light, you can say, you know, set a time, turn my smart plug on, and then you can select repeat, 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 and save. And then you can also come in and use this to turn off the smart plug on these specific days and times. Timer, so this is allowing you to either turn on or off your smart plug after a set amount of time. Generally, you want to turn it off after a certain amount of time. So think of it as like a mandatory sleep timer for children if you wanted to. So you can come in here 30 minutes, turn off, and then start. So after being on for 30 minutes, it will turn itself off. Away mode, this is to allow the plug to act as if somebody was home. So again, if it's plugged into a light, you can set a specific time to start this action and end this action. And what it will actually do is turn on and off that device. So if it is plugged into a TV, it will turn on and off the power to the TV. And if your TV was left in the on state, will turn that on and off during the specific time frame. And again, you can select repeating on what day. So if you just wanted to do it while you're away on the weekends, you can do it during that. You would just click start, and right there, it's getting ready to. We're just going to say stop because we don't actually want to do that. Last bit, which makes this very interesting to me, is this energy usage. So here it will show you today. Currently, the Roku is using 2.8 watts and total consumption for the day is less than 0.01. Now, daily average is a little, well, it's very low for the Roku because it doesn't use a lot, even though it's last year's top tier model review over there. We're gonna come back here and we're gonna swipe to something like the Drobo, which does use quite a bit of power. So here we can see it's currently using 3.1 watts. It has a total consumption of almost, well, not even quite half a kilowatt yet. But if we come down to the 7-day average, here's the daily average for what it actually uses. Here's the total consumption. So I've actually used a kilowatt and a half in the past 7 days. Coming down to the past 30 days, again, it's not quite a full kilowatt, but the total consumption is 5.03 kilowatts. Now, this is really nice information to have, especially if you are very concerned about power usage. The one thing I wish that it did show was actually the time. The other TP-Link smart plug I have has time, but not power usage, so it's kind of a trade-off. They won't give you both, they give you either or. Now, coming back here, you will notice that Drobo is up here, but PlayStation, plug, Roku, and TV, which are my other items on that power strip, are down there. It is kind of because it's alphabetical in the smart plug listing. So there's no way to get around that in this particular interface, but it doesn't matter. For me, I use the Echo in order to turn on and off my devices, as well as, you know, the Google Home, which you saw me power on. But that was a quick look at what the Kasa app looks like when using your power strip.